Hello and welcome to part 6 of our SEH Overwrite module. In the last part, we identified the bad characters, and in this part, we'll finally generate the shellcode using MSF Venom and integrate that shellcode into a POC, run that POC in our target application, and finally obtain a shell. So these are the few software that I'm assuming that you as a learner have a basic knowledge of. If you don't, or if you want to learn more about the software or the techniques that we are using in this module, please check out the resources mentioned at the end of this video. So this is our module structure. We are on part 6, that is cracking the shell. So in this part, we'll run this command which will generate our payload that we will integrate into our PLF file. So we will be using MSF Venom, which is a module of Metasploit framework, and we'll be specifying a Windows Metapreter reverse TCP payload. We'll specify the options as lhost and lport. So lhost is that IP address of my attacking machine, and lport is the port on which we will be listening for the reverse shell. And we'll also specify the bad characters that we identified in the last part. So these are hex 00, hex 0a, and hex 1a, and we need the output in the form of Python. Then we'll run multi-handler in Metasploit to listen to the reverse connection that is sent by the target over port 4444. So let's move this to the lab. So here I have the POC from the last part. Now I'll move to my Kali machine and generate the payload. So this is the command that I will be using, and I'll hit enter. It takes some time to generate the payload. So this is a payload. I'll copy it, and it is 368 bytes in size, and it is encoded using x86 Shikata Ga Nai encoder, and it has used 0 iterations. And I'll replace the bad characters variable with my payload and save this, and I'll move back to my Kali machine. Now I'll open a new terminal window and run MSF console and use multi-handler, set payload as TCP, show options. So it requires 3 options, and all these are mandatory options as mentioned under the required column. So we already have exit function as process. We'll not touch this argument or option. We have lport also set to 4444. We'll also not touch this because this is what we have specified in our payload above. So all we need to do is set the lhost argument. So set lhost as 192.168.43.28 and run. So now our multi-handler is listening for a reverse shell on this host on port 4444. I'll move back to my XP machine. So here is a POC, and I'll now generate a new PLF file using this POC. Great. Now I'll open Immunity Debugger and open DVD X Player in it. Run the application. Later. Now I'll set a breakpoint to the memory address or the memory pointer to pop return instruction, which is and I'll open the new PLF file. So we have hit our first buffer overflow. I'll pass this to the application using Shift F9, and we have hit our breakpoint, and now I'll trace into it, return. Now we'll take a short jump to our shellcode. Now if I play from here, the shellcode should run and we should receive a reverse shell on our Kali machine. And now I'll move back to my Kali machine, and we have a Metapreter session 1 opened here. Let's see if it get a command line. Yeah. So we finally have a command line. And what I'll do is I'll first verify if we have the correct machine. I'll run get UID. So we are on the correct machine because I have these username, or I have this username on my Windows XP SP3 machine. I will try to elevate my privileges using get system command. So this time we have got the system via technique one, and now we have the administrator access for this machine. Again, I'll verify this using the get UID command. So we have entity authority system. And if you want to drop into the Windows command shell, all you have to do is type shell and it will take you to the Windows command line. Here you can specify any of the Windows terminal commands and they will run just fine. To exit out of it and go back to Metaprator command, all you have to do is type exit and you'll be back into the Metaprator shell. Run the help command and play around with Metaprator. So I am in Metaprator help here, and this command seems to be interesting. Screenshot. Let's run this command and grab a screenshot of our target machine. Let's see what we get. So it has saved this to root and this file. So let's see what this file holds. So this is the file returned by Metaprator, and this is the screenshot of the desktop of a target machine, which we can verify from here. Great. So these are the few learning resources that you can use to learn more about the software or the techniques that we were using in this module. These resources will help you from learning these software and techniques from scratch as well. So thank you for watching this video, and I'll see you in the next module. And thank you for being part of our exploit development series. We'll continue to develop more modules in the future. Meanwhile, please subscribe to our channel YakshasCSC and follow us on Twitter. Our Twitter handle is @Yakshas443. And if you want files for any of the modules, all you have to do is tweet about any of the modules, mention our Twitter handle. And once we receive your tweet, we'll send you the link to download files via Twitter DM.